So I have this somewhat hairy function definition here, and I want to see if we can graph it. And this is a piecewise function. It's defined as a different, essentially different lines. You see this right over here, even with all the decimals and the negative signs, this is essentially a line. It's defined by this line over this interval for x, this line over this interval of x, and this line over this interval of x. I want to see if we can graph it. And I encourage you, especially if you have some graph paper, to see if you could graph this on your own first before I work through it. So let's think about this first interval. When negative 10 is less than or equal to x, which is less than negative 2, then our function is defined by negative 0.125x plus 4.75. So this is going to be a line, a downward sloping line. And the easiest way I can think about graphing it is let's just plot the endpoints here and then draw the line. So when x is equal to 10, when x is equal to negative 10, so we would have negative 0, actually let me write it this way. Let me do it over here where I do the, so we're going to have negative 0.125 times negative 10 plus 4.75. That is going to be equal to, let's see, the negative times the negative is a positive, and then 10 times this is going to be 1.25 plus 4.75. That is going to be equal to 6. So we're going to have the point negative 10 comma 6, and that point, and it includes, so x is defined there, it's less than or equal to, and then we go all the way to negative 2. So when x is equal to negative 2, we have negative 0.125 times negative 2 plus 4.75 is equal to, see, negative times negative is positive, 2 times this is going to be positive 0.25 plus 4.75, it's going to be equal to positive 5. Now, we might be tempted to just circle in this dot over here, but remember, this interval does not include negative 2. It's up to negative 2, not including. So I'm gonna put a little open circle there, and then I'm gonna draw the line. I am going to draw my best attempt at the line. Now let's do the next interval. And this one's a lot more straightforward. We start at x equals negative 2. When x equals negative 2, negative 2 plus 7 is 5. So negative 2 comma 5. So it actually includes that point right over there. So we're actually able to fill it in. And then when x is negative 1, negative 1 plus 7 is going to be positive 6. Positive 6, but we're not including x equals negative 1, up to and including. So it's going to be right over here. When x is negative 1, we are approaching, or as x approaches negative 1, we're approaching negative 1 plus 7 is 6. So that's that interval right over there. And now let's look at this last interval. This last interval, when x is negative 1, you're going to have, well, this is just going to be positive 12 over 11, because we're multiplying it by negative 1, plus 54 over 11, which is equal to 66 over 11, which is equal to positive 6. So we're able to fill in that right over there. And then when x is equal to 10, you have negative 120 over 11. I just multiplied this times 10. 12 times 10 is 120, and we have the negative. Plus 54 over 11. So this is the same thing. This is going to be, what is this? This is negative 66 over 11. Is that right? Let's see if you, yeah, that is negative 66 over 11, which is equal to negative 6. So when x is equal to 10, our function is equal to negative 6. And so this one actually doesn't have any jumps in it. It could have, but we see. So there we have it. We have graphed this function that has been defined in a piecewise way.